So T from Assam. Okay, Assam. So Pranjol, a youngster from Assam or Assam, is Rajveer's classmate at school in Delhi. Pranjol's father is the manager of a tea garden in Upper Assam, and Pranjol has invited Rajveer to visit his home during the summer vacation. So people in Delhi, they have not seen tea plantations, right? So it is a big curiosity that Rajveer is going to see, right? So two friends, Pranjol and Rajveer, okay? And Rajveer is there going to Assam to see the tea plantations. Have you seen tea plantations? Yes. Okay. So what about the tea plantations? What about the plucking of the leaf? What do you know about that? Ladies kar rahi hoti hai. Piche they tie the basket. Gents do nothing. Okay. Yes. It has to be done patiently. So men don't have patience, is it? No, but many women are employed, yes. And is there any particular leaf they pluck or anything they come across? They have, yes. So, you know, like what we see, if you look carefully at, you know, some packets of tea, I think so, consume a lot of tea, isn't it, right? So, you see that picture there, it is two leaves and a bud. That is the way it is. Plucked, right? And does it happen throughout the year? Is it there? No. So there's a season. Yes. So when the plucking, it takes place. What happens after the leaves have been plucked? Yes. What happens? They are dried. Then what happens later on? They're dried and they're made into this tea leaves that you get, is it? Yes. So what about it? That means all the tea leaves are the same quality?
No.
Then there is a difference there, right? And we're going to read about that. It is there, you know, like also depending upon the leaves that are plucked and how long they are dried and all that. So we have different varieties of tea also. Yes, so you have your Earl Grey, you have your Darjeeling, you have your Assam tea, isn't it? You have your King, all these are there. You know, you have a lot of variety of teas. So those are the companies who are there, right? Who are packaging it and sending it to our markets and our shops, okay? So your Taj Mahal or your Brook Bond and all, that is, yeah, red label. Yeah, okay, right. Thank you, ma'am. Abhi. Go from that side. Complaints, isn't it? Okay, so right, let's continue the chapter. So we were discussing about tea and who are the two friends who are going to go there? We have Pranjol and Rajveer. And who does not belong to Assam? Is it Pranjol or Rajveer? Rajveer. So he's excited to visit the tea plantation. Okay. And so when you want to, go somewhere, a place which has, it is popular for its cultivation, would you read about it in advance or you want to learn their on-hand experience? You will read about it in advance. So that's a good thing to do, isn't it? Right? So you have also read, maybe in your geography lessons or in other subjects about tea, about coffee, about spices. So we know how they looks like, isn't it? Have you seen any spices grow?
Yes.
Which one? Yeah. clove, dalchini. How does dalchini grow? I know. No, how does it grow? How does dalchini grow? I would love to see that. Bay leaf. You've seen bay leaf also? Okay, so that is also quite popular. What about those, that black pepper, kali mirch that we call? So if you go down south, you'll see these spices. So yesterday we read about Coorg also, right? So the spices are there. You go even further here, you'll see cardamom growing, your elaichi, which you call, right? You will see these also spices, which you are talking about. And cardamom, you know, like your cinnamon, which is dalchini, it does not grow on a tree. Wo bark hi hota hai. It is the bark of a tree. Yeah, it's the bark of the tree. Yes. Phir koi aur hoga. Okay, right. Then any other spices you've seen? Red chili. Red chili. That's quite common. Yes. Right. What about turmeric and all? Have you seen that? वो तो घर पे ही उगा लेते हैं. Okay. Many of you have not. Yes. Right. Fine. So we have seen these, and you will see that the real product is very different from the packaged one. So the tea leaves are very different from the tea which you get in your packets, isn't it? Right. And they're dry. Okay. And they're sorted out. They're separated. And then finally we get the product. Okay. So let us start here. Chai garam garam chai. Avenger called out in a high-pitched voice. It's something very common you hear at the railway station, yes. Isn't it? Yes. He came up to the window and asked, Chai sir, give us 2 cups, Pranjol said. They sipped the steaming hot liquid. Almost everyone in the compartment was drinking tea too. Do you know that over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world? Did we know this? No, we did not. So it is one of the most consumed beverage. Okay, right, Rajveer said. Whew, exclaimed Pranjol. Tea really is very popular. And what about coffee? Do you think it is as popular? Yes, or it is becoming more popular. Because you have your latte and cappuccino and whatever, your frappuccino, whatever it is there. Isn't it? Yeah, your hazelnut and things like that. Isn't it? So tea is only tea. You either get your masala tea or something. Green tea, black tea. Do you think they really, of course, yeah, it's a lot of yes. So I was just asking if you're present in the class. So kahawa is also there. Yes. So the train pulled out of the station. Pranjol buried his nose in his detective book again. What does this mean? Buried his nose in his detective book again. He was reading a book, and yes, look at Hardik. Where's your book? You also bury your nose in your book. He wasn't listening only. Right? So Pranjol buried his nose in his detective book again. So what was Pranjol reading? A detective book. Rajveer too was an ardent fan of detective stories, but at the moment he was keener on looking at the beautiful scenery. So as they've entered the state of Assam, so he wants to see the beautiful scenery around him, right? What do you think he can see around him? Greenery and of course the plantation, the tea plantation. Yeah, it was green everywhere. Rajveer had never seen so much greenery before. Then the soft green paddy fields gave way to tea bushes. So first there were paddy fields. Have you seen paddy fields?
Yes.
What grows in the paddy field?
Yes.
Very good. Right. Okay. And once they passed the paddy fields, what could they see? The tea bushes, right? It was a magnificent view. Against the backdrop of densely wooded hills, a sea of tea bushes stretched as far as the eye could see. So in the background, what were there? The hills were there. And in the front, what was there? As far as they could see, it was the tea plantation. The tea bushes were there. Dwarfing the tiny tea plants were tall, sturdy shade trees. And amidst the orderly rows of bushes, busily move doll-like figures. Who are the doll-like figures? Doll-like figures. Scarecrows. They're moving. Moved doll-like figures. Who are the doll-like figures moving in there? The women who are plucking the leaves. Very good. Very nice. So, right? From a distance, it seemed that, you know, the way they were doing the work, everyone in the same way, just picking and putting it in the basket, isn't it? And they do it so quickly. Right? And perfection. Moved the doll-like figures. In the distance was an ugly building with smoke billowing out of tall chimneys. Yes, so the furnaces, industries there. So it was everything. It was beautiful nature. And in the distance, there was the industries also, right? And the chimneys there from which the smokes were coming. Hey, a tea garden, Rajveer cried excitedly. Rajveer is excited because he's never seen a tea garden before. Pranjol, who had been born and brought up on a plantation, didn't share Rajveer's excitement. So he did not find it very excitement. He is used to all this. He's grown up there. Oh, this is tea country now, he said. Assam has the largest concentration of plantations in the world. You will see enough gardens to last you a lifetime. So wherever you're going to go, you're going to see tea gardens. Bhavan, please stand up. Stand up, Bhavan. Tell me what we have read. Come here. Where's the book? Then what are you doing in the classroom? Come in the front. Yes, Chirag, you tell me. Why was Rajveer so excited to see the tea gardens? You're not listening? Vansh? Your Dhruv? Oh, Vansh? Your Vansh? And you are Dhruv. Dhruv, stand up. Dono Vansh. Okay. Okay, Vansh, please stand up. Tell me, why was Rajveer so excited to see the tea garden? Yes, next. Yes, very good. Hardik, please stand up. Yes. What was the information that Rajveer has shared about tea?
Over 80 crores of plants every day, and Assam has the largest concentration of
tea in the world. Very nice, very good. Sit down and be attentive in the class. Okay? Bhavin, open your book. Hardik and Raghav, you can have a discussion later. And Hardik, you have to work very hard. Either you work very hard, then you're called to the principal's office, or you don't work hard. Then you're called. Two conditions, right? Decide which condition you want to fulfill. Decided? Yes. So you will see enough gardens to last your lifetime. So the students have joined me right now. What is it that we're discussing about? Two friends. Who are the two friends? Pranjol and Rajveer. And where are they going? They're going to Assam. And who is more excited? Rajveer is more excited because he has never seen a tea garden in his life. Right? And he's never seen so much greenery also. And as they move towards, you know, the tea plantations, they see the paddy fields first, and then they see the tea gardens. And they see the women working over there in that very, you can say, what, mechanical movement, right? And of course, yes, so Rajveer is there sharing lots of information. And he is not, you know, like, of course, his friend isn't busy reading a book because he has seen all this throughout his life. He's grown up there. That is not there exciting him so much. I have been reading as much as I could about tea, Rajveer said. No one really knows who discovered tea, but there are many legends. So there are many stories about it. What are they? What legends? Well, there's the one about the Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking it. One day, a few leaves of the twigs burning under the pot fell into the water, giving it a delicious flavor. It is said they were tea leaves. So one of the stories about the origin of tea was that the Chinese emperor, he would always boil his water before drinking it. And one day by accident, what happened? From the branches which were there under the pot, so leaves, they fell in the water. And the taste of the water changed, and the emperor liked that taste, right? So since then, it seems as if tea has become popular. Tell me another, scoffed Pranjal, scoffed, like it seems as he's heard them. Okay, tell me, what more have you read about? Yes, so he's not excited here. He's just, you know, like, of course, maybe teasing him because Pranjal might be knowing so much about tea, right? Not quite sure whether he knows about these legends. We have an Indian legend too, Bodhidharma. An ancient Buddhist ascetic cut off his eyelids because he fell sleepy during meditation. So he wanted to meditate, but he started feeling sleepy, right? So that he would not fall asleep. And so he just cut off his eyelids. 10 tea plants grew out of the eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put in hot water and drunk, banished sleep. Which of them could be a more realistic explanation? The Chinese emperor, right? Okay. Tea was first drunk in China, Rajveer added, as far back as 2700 BC, before Christ. In fact, words such as tea, chai, and chini are from Chinese. Tea came to Europe only in the 16th century and was drunk more as medicine than as beverage. And we always thought that the, you know, Britishers left behind the legacy of drinking tea, right? So it is the, once again, the Chinese here introduced tea. Anything else the Chinese have introduced? What? Fast food. Only Chinese have there. Yeah, I was waiting for that. Okay. Fast food. Only Chinese fast food we have. Italian also we have. Right? Yeah. South Indian. Okay. Is that is Indian fast food, we can say. Yes. Right? Okay. Yeah. Let's continue. The train clattered into Mariani Junction. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform. Pranjal's parents were waiting for them. Soon they were driving towards Dekhya Bari, the tea garden managed by Pranjal's father. An hour later, the car veered sharply off the main road. Veered sharply, turned off the main road. So then they were not on the main road now, they were away from it. They crossed the cattle bridge and entered the Dekhya Bari tea estate. On both sides of the gravel road were acre upon acre of tea bushes. So as far as I could see on both sides, what were there? Tea bushes. All neatly pruned to the same height. Pruned to the same height? They were cut to the same height. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. Pranjal's father slowed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of tea leaves to pass. A trailer load of tea leaves. This is the second flush of sprouting period. Isn't it, Mr. Barua? Rajveer asked. It lasts from May to July and yields the best tea. You seem to have done your homework before coming, Pranjal's father said in surprise. Yes, Mr. Barua, Rajveer admitted. But I hope to learn much more while I am here. So what have we learned about tea? It's a popular beverage, right? So about how many cups are drunk every day? And what about its origin? Its origin is from China, and there is an Indian legend also related to it. Yes, Bodhidharma and the Aztec then, and how the tea branches they grew out, and that they banish the sleep. Okay, right. So what about it here? What is the best season, or what's the best time of the year for the plucking? It's May to July. That is when they get the best tea. So right. So when we do segregate here, which is the best tea and all, it could be maybe on the basis of the season of their plucking, right? So when the tea is best. So do we, you know, we have tea tasters also on tea estates, on tea plantations. What is their job? That, yeah, so a tea quality. So to see that, yes, it is there, the best quality which has to be packed and sold. Okay, fine. Yes, so with this, I think so here. I'm just going to let us do this exercise. Look at these words. Page 96. Words are given here. Upkeep. Down pour. Undergo. Drop out. Walk in. Right? So, of course, so there's a verb in them. Yes or no? Keep and pour and go and all these right here. And an adverb. Yes. And or a particle. Up, down, under, out, in. Particle or a preposition it should be, isn't it? Now we are going to use these words in the sentences below. A heavy dash has been forecast due to low pressure in the Bay of Bengal. Very good. Heavy downpour. What does downpour mean? Rain, heavy rainfall. Rakesh will dash major surgery. Not like this, one at a time. Rakesh will undergo. And mark the answers in the book. My brother is responsible for the dash of a family property. Drop out, no. Upkeep. Upkeep means to take care. Yes, very good. The dash rate for this accountancy course is very high. What does dropout mean? Falling down, to leave. Leave. Yeah, dropout here is leave. Like, of course, we talk about that after 8th class or 10th class, there are many dropouts from school. Not necessarily in urban areas, but in rural areas. Right? Why? Because the school is far or other issues. So dropout, to leave, to not complete it. Right? So the dropout rate for this accountancy course is very high. It must be a difficult course. That's why. She went to the enterprise company to attend a dash interview. Walk-in interview. What do you think is a walk-in interview? Walk-in interview. What is a walk-in interview? To walk in. Acha, come. So here, otherwise, when we give an interview for any job, we have to apply beforehand, and so many formalities are there. You're shortlisted, you're called for an interview. But in a walk-in interview, the date is announced, and people who think they are eligible, they can just go and give the interview. So that's a walk-in. Okay? Right? So walk-in here. Yeah. Now let's here, right, let's do this here. We can now combine the verb with one of the words which is given in the box. Like there's a word throw in the bracket which is given. You can use the word from the box. The army attempted unsuccessfully to dash the government. Don't rush, take your time. Attempted overthrow, overthrow. Throw we're going to use, right? And overthrow. Very nice. What does overthrow mean? To take over? Yes. Scientists are on the brink of a major Breakthrough, very good. Break is given. Yes, you last boy, very nice. You make a pose and sit like that and do nothing. No one is going to compliment you for posing so nicely. Take out a pencil and start writing. Breakthrough. A major change, you know, major discovery, right? An important moment that has been there, you know, like which is going to bring a change in that research. Next is the state government plans to build a dash for Bhubaneswar bypass. Very nice. Okay, to speed up traffic on the main highway. Very good. Gautam's dash on life changed when he realized that the world is full of sorrow. Outlook. Outlook means vision, perspective. Yes, very nice. Rakesh seemed unusually dash after the game. Now, only one word is left. Downcast. Downcast means low, upset. Right? Fine? Clear? So we have here these words which are there. Now we are, I'm going to complete all the exercises here. So, right? So I think so with this, the period is also about to